Hi students, this is maths video for grade 2. Again we are going to see the same lesson, Judson marks. In the Judson marks, we are going to see the remaining part. Now open your book to the page number 53. Thirsty Crow. I think you remember this story. The Chippy Crow was very thirsty. It looked everywhere but could not find water. Suddenly it saw a pitcher. Pitcher in Hindi they will tell matka. Suddenly it saw one pot. When it tried to drink water, it found there was a very little water in the pitcher. See, little water only in the pitcher. So, now Crow thought, I have an idea. It saw a bubbles lying nearby. Bubbles means that koolangal. We have to tell, no, kutikutikal. It saw a bubbles lying nearby. Then, it put the bubbles into the pitcher one by one. He take the bubbles and put it into the pitcher one by one. Now the water came up. Chirpy drank water and flew away. How the water came up? Because when the bubbles go inside the pot, it occupies some space of the water. So the water came up. Turn the next page. Do you want to be a chirpy? Do you want to be like chirpy? Do you want to know how the water in the pitcher came up? Now only I explained that. Now this activity for you. Take two glasses of the same size and fill half of each glass with water. Have to put some tamarind seeds. Tamarind means in Hindi we have to tell imli. Okay, in the first glass. Rise the water to the top. You just add the tamarind seeds into the first glass and rise the water to the top. Guess how many seeds you will need to put in. Now do it. First you guess the, next you do that. Count the number of seeds you used. You count the seeds. Next, now put the same number of marbles in the second glass. What happened? See, now I am telling, guessing only. See, you used, I think, more than 70. If you take a big glass, you have to use 70 seeds or 50. Now put the same number of marbles in the second. If you used 50 seeds, you used 50 marbles. What happens if you pour, if you put 10 marbles, the water will rise to the top. Why? Because small object occupies small space in the water. But big object like a marble and then bubbles, it will occupy more space in the water. Next, water is useful. Find out how much water in mugs or bucket is used in your house for each of the following. Find out how much water in mugs or buckets is used in your house for each of the following. See, for bathing, how many buckets you used? You used one bucket of water used for taking bath. Next, for washing cloth, we need two buckets of water. Next, for washing vessels, you used two buckets. But nowadays, we won't use the bucket of water to wash the vessels. Simply, we are wash the vessels in the wash basins. Otherwise, in the sink. Next, for drinking purpose, how many have we used mugs or bucket? We used mugs. Two mugs of water. For drinking purpose, we used two mugs of water. Next, guess and then find out. How many mugs of water fill one bucket? How many mugs of water fill one bucket? Now I am going to write approximately 15 mugs. 15 or 16 or 20 according to the bucket size. Okay, according to the bucket size, how many mugs of water fill in one bucket? How many buckets of water do you use to take a bath? How many buckets of water do you use to take a bath? I used two buckets of water to take bath. If you used one bucket of water, you write here one bucket. Next, how many mugs of water do you use to take a bath? How many mugs of water do you use to take a bath? See, one bucket it fill 15 mug means two bucket. One bucket is equal to 15 mugs means, that means 15 mugs of water means, two bucket means we have to multiply 15 into 2. 2 5s are 10, carry 1, 2 1 is 2, you want to add the carry, 2 plus 1, 3. So 30 mugs for 2 buckets, 30 mugs. See, I used 2 buckets of water. So how many mugs of water do you use to take bath? I used 30 mugs. Next, how much water will fill in a balloon? How much of water will fill in a balloon? One mug. This is also according to the size of the balloon. If you take a big size, it will hold two mug also. But if you take a small size balloon, it will take up half mug, otherwise one mug of water. Next, how much water is need to fill a gun? Water gun. How much water is need to fill a water gun? That means pichkari. In the holy time, not here. In North Indian time, they will used to pour the colored water to other person. So, how much water is needed to fill a water gun? That means pichkari. I think two mugs it will hold. Two mugs. This one also according to the size of the water gun. Next, I can drink. See the camel. I can drink 9 buckets of water at once. I can drink 9 buckets of water at once. How many buckets can 2 camels drink at once? Here, like this. See, one camel drink. How many buckets? 9 buckets. They asked 2 camels. 2 camels means simply we want to multiply 2 into 9. One camel drink 9 buckets. 2 camel means we want to multiply that 2 into 9. Next, 2 9s are 18 buckets. So how many buckets can two camels drink at once? 18 buckets. In your home, you just do this activity and share your experience with your family members. I hope you understood this lesson. Thank you, children.